Hey, welcome to my fun, easy, and a new project. Come, join me and we will do wonders again.
Hi, this is Smriti from Simply Crafted for Handmade Today. So today we are going to make a very interesting project, a very simple and easy yet very classy. So we need any MDF base. I have used hearts, you can use any. And after that I will be using a decoupage napkin on top of it. And to use the decoupage napkin we will use the decoupage glue. And later we will varnish it with decoupage varnish. For the paints I have used Chalky Paints Snow White and Chalky Paints French Rose. Then we will also do some reactive foil work on this. So for that we have used a stencil, which is a maize stencil. This is a 6x6 stencil, and on this I will be using foil magic, to which I will be using reactive foil rose gold. And towards the end, for the edges, for the reactive foil again I will be using tacky glue. Now these are the products that we all need and make an awesome project. So what are we waiting for? Come, let's see what are we making today. So to start with, we will do gesso or gesso on our MDF base. I am doing the first coat with brush. The second coat I will do with the brush, but then I will also use a little foam roller on top of it to create very slight texture. After that, I will start applying the napkin. So now firstly I need to decide what part of the napkin am I going to use. So I'm going to cut out 1/4 of the napkin and then decide how am I going to place it on my MDF hearts. After understanding the position where I want the birds to come, I'm going to apply the decoupage glue and then press the napkin on top of it and then sand the edges so that I have a clean edge and it's easy for me to paint later. So I have placed the napkin on both the MDF hearts, and now that I have done sanding also, I'm going to seal it with a layer of Mod Podge, something which I always keep stressing about. This is a very, very important step. Now for the edges, I'm just going to paint it with my fingertips, and for the paint I have used French Rose Chalky Paints, and it was actually very easy to use with my fingertips. So for every project I like to do something different. Here I like to use my fingertips, and whatever was left on my plate I applied it with white chalky paint Snow White color, and I applied it at the back of these hearts, and the back was painted. Easy peasy. So the edges, I always like to give a little bit of sponging. I think the effect comes out really nice. Do try it. I'm sure you will also like it. Now that the base is done, it is time for us to add the X factor.
Yes, whenever we do stamping, stenciling or anything like that, it's basically to bring out the project even better, to bring out the X factor into the project. So here I'm going to use a stencil which is called Maze. It is a 6x6 stencil and I will do stenciling with Foil Magic. And once the Foil Magic is completely dry, 100% dry, it becomes transparent. That is when I will start applying the reactive foils on top of it. And then rub and burnish the reactive foils really well. Over here you can also see that I'm using a leftover reactive foil from my previous project. Yes, I hate to waste my supplies. So yes, you can also do the same. Whatever reactive foil is left, always make sure that you keep it in a container to work on the next project. So for the reactive foils, always remember that you really need to burnish it well. Maybe 2-3 times or 5 times, and if you think that you're done, just repeat the whole process 5 times again. That is when you get the best result. For the sides, I'm going to use tacky glue and make it a little tacky and use some reactive foils on the side. It gives a very beautiful edging and a very beautiful effect. So that is it. Once the sides are done, it is time for me to attach the rope at the back. I'm going to use a jute rope to attach at the back so that I can hang them anywhere. And my God, what a beautiful, cute little project. I am just in love with this. I hope you liked it too, and I hope you will make this. Please do make it. Please do comment. Please do tell me how do you like it. It really means a lot to me. So I will wait for your comments and I will wait for your product pictures. Bye, see ya, have fun, enjoy yourself and be good.